Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Listen, getting your first dog is a big thing. And if you watch a lot of my videos, folks will say that most dog breeds that you'll find here aren't for beginners. But we all have to start somewhere. And for those of you who do not want a little dog or don't want a medium-sized dog, but you want a giant breed, I'm going to give you 5 giant dog breeds for beginners. All right, now let me first say this. Being a beginner does not mean that you are not an active dog owner. It doesn't mean that you're not an interested dog owner. It doesn't mean that you get to be a lazy dog owner. Beginner means that you just don't have much experience. There's other ways to mitigate lack of experience. One of the best ways to mitigate lack of experience is to watch Dogumentary TV. I believe this channel is a great resource for research. But there's tons of things. You have the internet, there are books, there are breed clubs, there are other YouTube channels. Again, being a beginner simply means you don't have any experience owning dogs. It doesn't mean that you're not educating yourself. It doesn't mean that you're not researching, seeking out information, and getting a mentor within the breed to help you out. If you do these things, most competent people will have very little or no issue dealing with a giant dog breed. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Click the notification bell. And if you want to, you can become a channel member. Just hit the join button. It goes a long way in supporting the work that I do, and I definitely appreciate it. All right, guys, let's jump into this video. 5 giant dog breeds for beginners. At number 5, I have the Bull Mastiff. Bull Mastiff is number 5 because it is the giant dog breed on my list with the most downside. It's a great dog. They're gentle, but they are working dogs. They do have guarding instinct. And if you find one with a high energy and a high defense drive, they can be a lot to handle for a beginner. And that's why they're the 5th ranked breed on my list. And for full disclosure, while the Bull Mastiff is ranked 5th on my list, this would be, for me, out of the 5 dog breeds, my first choice for myself and for my own home. All right, guys, next on the list, the Leonberger. Another giant dog breed that is very easy to own. Now, Leonbergers, once they start to mature, like 2 or 3 years old, they do become bolder and a bit more protective. The great thing about that delayed boldness is that it gives a beginner some time to acquaint themselves with the breed and to gain some experience with dog ownership. All dog breeds on this list don't have a whole lot of dog aggression, but that is not to be confused with no dog aggression. Most, if not all, dog breeds for the most part have a certain level of same-sex aggression. So understand that even getting a Leonberger, you're going to want to watch him around other males, especially if the males are still intact. Next up on my list is the Newfoundland, another amazing giant dog breed that's very easy to own. The Newfie, like other breeds on this list, has a very low exercise requirement. These dogs are low energy. Not a tremendous amount of prey drive in any of the breeds on this list. But they all do require a certain amount of exercise. Every dog should get exercise. Every dog should get out of the house. In addition to exercising these dogs, you also want to socialize them. Big dogs, just like little dogs, can be fearful of things that they don't know. So at a very young age, you want to introduce them to as many things, sights, sounds, smells, people as possible. Make the dog as confident as possible, which should give you a very stable giant dog breed. Next on my list, I have the Saint Bernard. One of the things that you will find common on this list, these dogs will be great with people, great with children, and have very little dog aggression. The Saint Bernard, like every other breed on this list, will need obedience training. Every dog has a mind of its own, and sometimes they want to go in a direction that you're not pointing them to. That becomes a struggle, especially if you haven't obedience trained your dog. So the Saint Bernard is a great dog, very loving, very tender, very gentle, easy to own, but will need obedience training. All right, guys, last on my list, the number 1 giant dog breed for beginners, the Bernese Mountain Dog. A wonderful dog, very gentle, very sweet. Does have some watchdog qualities, which means they will alert to strange things entering into their environment. Not very likely to move on them. Breed is not a guard dog. Doesn't have very much guarding instincts, but it is a very versatile dog. Does things from carting. I believe it does a little light herding, more so like droving, I guess is what it would be called. But Burmese Mountain Dogs are very amazing animals, just like every dog on this list. Has a sweet temperament, very gentle, very affectionate, easy around people, very easy around children. The biggest knock I have on the Burmese Mountain Dog is that they are one of the shorter-lived dog breeds. Really hoping at some point breeders and veterinary scientists can figure out what's going on with the Burmese Mountain Dogs, because they are wonderful animals. And it would be great that families that choose to bring these dogs into their home, it would be great if they could have them a lot longer. All right, guys. So this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. This is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys enjoy this content, please give it a thumbs up. And if you really want to support the channel, take a look at the join button. Become a channel member. It would be greatly appreciated. All right, guys. Peace.
Yeah. Life is brief. Don't let that get you down. Don't let that get you down. It's all gonna go away soon, but there ain't no's to you. Why you so upset about it? Life is brief. Don't let that get you down.